haven't done too much damage to my metabolism. What I eat in a day in Italy.
Take on board your votes, and I'm definitely going to go for...
Hi guys, welcome back to another weekly weigh-in. How have you been? Have you lost, gained, maintained? Let me know in the comments down below. How was your week gone? How have you coped with the heat? Oh my word. What an insane weekend that was of heat. Well, weekend, it went last Tuesday, didn't it? Absolutely insane. Melting, that's all I can say. You know, I know us Brits, we love to complain about the weather. It's because we're just not equipped for it. We're just not equipped to deal with it, you know. Most places, you know, if you live in a really hot country, you'd probably have an air conditioning unit. And we think, what's the point for the 2 days we get here? We're not going to do it, are we? Anyway. So, how has this week gone? Well, if you saw last week's weekly weigh-in. I don't even know what I'm saying, guys. It's been a long week. If you saw last week's weigh-in, you know that this week I decided to do a reverse diet. So 1700 was my calorie goal for this week. I actually went over that, so it was about 1755, and that's at a best guess, because if you've watched one of my, if you watched my last Sunday's video, you'd know I was doing my kitchen makeover. So that put my kitchen out of action for 3 days, when I couldn't really cook in it, so toast I could do, anything on toast, which resulted in a couple of takeaways, which, bearing in mind, I don't normally, if I have one takeaway every 3 months, that's it, so to have... two, in fact, I had three in that week, is quite unheard of for me these days. So I counted the best I could. So would it be higher than that? I suspected so, because on Monday I did do a quick weigh-in and I put on something like 2.2 pounds on the Monday, which left me slightly worried, because even though yes, I had the takeaways, I was so unbelievably busy. I only either ate breakfast or lunch. I never ate both. So I was like, what's going on here? Then what that did then was fed into my insecurities of, oh, have I reduced my metabolism too much? Because I've been in a deficit for such a long time, even though I take the breaks. Have I done that? Have I slowed my metabolism down too much? So I had all these insecurities go through my head. And then it was that usual thing of, so what am I going to do? How am I going to be able to keep this off? I've never been able to keep it off before. So what's going to be the difference this time? Oh, so everything went through my head at that point. And I was, yeah, I don't know what to say. Other than I was very much doubting my ability to not only just lose the rest of the weight, but to keep it off once I got there. Very much a crisis of confidence this week, I have to say. But I will say it's probably not wise to worry too much when you don't have a clear picture, because I was busy, I wasn't in my usual routine, I wasn't cooking, I was eating takeaways, which isn't normally part of my daily life anyway. I would not ordinarily live my life that way, even not on a weight loss journey, even not in a deficit. I wouldn't live my life that way anyway. So it was probably a silly time to think about it, but it went through my head nevertheless. And you know me, guys, I like to be completely honest with you, because this journey is tough and it's full of so many ups and downs that we go through. And sometimes we think, is it just us? And it's not. We all go through these insecurities, we all have these momentary lapses in judgment, we all have these what ifs, and sometimes they're not based on anything, sometimes they are, but it's tough. And I will always be honest with you, if I've had a really rubbish week, you know, I will tell you. If I've had a really good week, I will tell you. If I've had a rubbish week, I'll tell you why. And if I've had a good week, I will tell you why, so that, you know, it might help somebody, basically. So that was my best guess, but I suspect it was probably more than that, because I didn't track very accurately. And some of it was done retrospectively, and that's never a good way to track your calories retrospectively, you know, the next day, because you forget stuff. Steps this week, 7,389. I was quite pleased that I managed to get to that many in on average in a day, because of the hot weather. It was you just didn't want to go out in it. I gotta be honest, you just didn't want to go out. All I wanted to do was sit in the house in front of the fan because it was ridiculous. But obviously as well, I was busy over the weekend doing my kitchen makeover, so I actually racked up quite a lot of steps doing that, just constantly moving around all day. So I'm really pleased to hit where I was. Yes, I want to still keep on hitting and striving for that constant 8,000. But you know, some weeks you lose, some weeks you win, some weeks you lose. So yeah, I'm not too dissatisfied about that. Now, resistance training. I haven't actually done any formal resistance training this week, but I did spend 3.5 days over the weekend lifting heavy cabinet doors, and those cabinet doors are incredibly heavy, even to the point when I said to my husband, do me a favour, give me a hand to take some of these back inside, so they could, I didn't want them, or leave them out overnight. And he was like, oh wow, they're heavy. And I was like, yeah, they are. And I was like, carrying two at a time. So I put that down as my weight resistance training for this week, because I lifted a lot of weight over those 3 days. Back and forth, squatting, you know, step ups on stuff, up and down the stool. So yes, I take it as that. So my muscle mass has gone down a bit, but I don't think it's that, it's my water weight. So when I've looked at it, my water weight is down, because obviously we've dropped back to more normal temperatures. So, and I do think when I look at what Monday looked like, I was definitely retaining fluid at that point. I mean, we all would be. And I think everybody, no matter who I look at, who I talk to, who I look at on the other channels, most people are gaining weight over this period, or at least still retaining some fluid. So I kind of put it down to that. So how did it go? I mean, I think the positives were, is that because I was eating more, I had so much more energy, my moods were so much better, my sleep, despite the heat, was so much better. So I definitely see a massive upturn for me on the days where I'm either eating at maintenance, or eating just under maintenance, or even eating slightly over maintenance. I do notice quite a significant change in myself for the positive. And again, like I said this last week, you know, it puts so much strain on us, and our body down regulates so many of our systems when we're in a deficit, because we don't have the calories to spend on it. It's really quite insane, and I think I see this more now than ever, because I do this cycling, that when I really have a good feed week, I notice a massive upturn in everything, absolutely everything, which is really quite interesting to observe. Yeah, really, really interesting. Anything else good about this week? Yeah, no, I think it's just that. More energy, better mood, better sleep, you know. And that's 2 weeks on the trot now of eating more and feeling better for it. The only downside was if I can get my steps in, but I'm, like I said, I'm not too sad about that. So the goal for next week, before I tell you how I did, the goal for next week is 1800 calories, because I'm doing this reverse ready for holidays, because I don't want my body to, like I said before, go, oh, let's hold on to all those calories, because it's not used to it. So 1800 is the goal for next week, and I'm really, really, really aiming to track everything, just if nothing else, to give myself a good understanding about where I am with my calories. If I go slightly over, because my maintenance is around 1950, if I go over, I'm not worried. I'm really, really not worried, because, you know, I'm always testing. I wanted to test to make sure that I haven't done too much damage to my metabolism, that it hasn't slowed down too much because of the deficit, that my diet cycling is keeping my baseline up enough, at least, to slow down that metabolic slide, if you know what I mean, because that's what I'm trying to do, is limit the damage. I know it's going to slow eventually, and I know to get to my target weight, I'm going to have to be far stricter on my calories, and I'm going to have to drop my calories, and which means then that my baseline metabolism will come down, and I will have to do something about that eventually. But for now, I'm trying to keep it as high as I can. So that my deficit can still be there to higher calories, if that makes sense. So, my measurements will stay the same this week. Nothing's changed. All measurements are the same, which is good as well. So how did I actually do this week? Well, despite the 2.2 gain on Monday, I actually got on the scales this morning and I was at 0.1 of a pound loss. So dead happy with that. So we call it a maintenance, really. I know every little bit helps, and it does. But we'll call it a maintenance, and I'm dead happy to come out of the maintenance by the end of this week, because I was worrying, to say the least. So many worries this week based around that, about what I would mean for the future. But anyway, I've already explained that, so let's not get into it. So that's it, guys. That is it for me for my week. You will get a final weekly weigh-in before I go to Italy next Thursday. I am going to Italy on Thursday, so I will be filming this quickly, uploading it before I leave. Fingers crossed. Yes, so obviously, going forward, I'll explain a bit more probably on the weekend. Going forward, there's not going to be a weekly weigh-in while I'm away. So the first one you'll get may actually be September, because by the time I actually come back, we'll be more or less into September. So it's going to be a month free of weekly weigh-in, so I'm not going to be weighing at all. So that's going to be fun when I come back. So no weekly weigh-ins. Obviously, I'm taking you to Italy with me, so you'll see all my travel-y vlog bit, and obviously I'll do a what I eat in a day in Italy. I've got to do those. So I'll keep those up. But what I may do is, I may film quite a few what I eat in a days within the sort of the first week to give you a good snapshot of what it's like, so I can actually take a bit of time off while I'm in Italy. So I might try and pre-record some stuff while I'm there, where I can, so you've got some content through the summer, but I can actually take a break, because at some point I think I do need to just pop the camera down and take probably 2 weeks out of the three where I'm just not doing anything. I'm just really resting and stopping, I think. So yes, but I will endeavour to film the content just to bridge that gap, if that makes sense. So that's it, guys. If you've enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you're new around here, consider subscribing, because I've got lots more content coming up when I come back. Well, during Italy, when I come back from Italy, you know, all my weight loss stuff, because I'm still striving to get to that target weight of another about 2.5 stone, really, is what I'm looking at. Plus as well, some other content that I'm weaving in along the way of my very simple life. Oh, and, if you're still sticking around and hear this, give me a send emoji in the comments so I know which ones of you are stuck through to the end. In saying that, I forgot what I was going to say. Channel rebranding, yes. So I have taken on board your vote, and I'm definitely going to go for Simply Adele, because that is what most people have voted for, and I think it was the one that I liked the most as well myself, probably way up on the top. So I will rebrand the channel, but that will come when I come back from the summer. So I might do some working on the channel branding while I'm out in Italy, because there will be moments where idle hands. So I will tinker, because I'll have time. So I will look to rebrand the channel from the Holistic Dieter to Simply Adele when I come back. So it's not just about, it's going to be very much still weight loss, healthy eating. That will always be the core of my channel. Always, always, always be the core of my channel. Always be the core of my channel, because cooking, I enjoy healthy eating. I'm definitely on a mission to make myself as healthy as possible the older I get. So that will always be a core. So if you're worrying that the reasons you joined this channel is because, and they're going to be going, they're not. They'll definitely be my core. But being my true spirit of the holistic, it's going to be other parts of my life as well, things that contribute to the balance, which helps me with my weight loss, helps me with keeping it off. So yeah, it's going to be everything. And that's it. Stop rambling now. So I will see you in this weekend's video. Bye, guys.